نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته وقال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد واصبر على ما يقولون واهجرهم هجرا جميلا وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا سفيان جئتكم بخير الدنيا وكرامة الآخرة أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Respected listeners, we still have the month of Muharram. Muharram is the beginning of the Islamic year for Muslims. It's the month from which the Islamic year begins. January, February, March are also the months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna iddata shuhur inda Allahi ithna ashra shahran fi kitabillah. Yawma qalaqa as-samawati wal-ard minha arba'atun hurum. Thalika ad-deenul qayyim. Fala tadhlimu fihinna anfusakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are 12 months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has made 12 months in a year. From how long? يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. From the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, Allah says we have made 12 months in a year. January, February, March till December, 12 months are also the months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the sun belongs to Allah, الشَّمْسُ تَجْرِي وَالشَّمْسُ تَزِيلُ مُفْتَقَرِ لَهَا ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. Muharram, Safar, Rabiul Awwal, Til, Dhul Hijjah are also 12 months, the months of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the moon belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْقَمَرُ قَدَّرْنَاهُ مَنَازِلَ حَتَّى عَادَ كَالْرُجُومِ الْقَدِيمِ لَالشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَنْ تُدْرِكَ الْقَمَرَ وَلَلَّيْلُ سَابِقُ النَّهَارِ وَكُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liked the lunar months better, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all of us. Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given the solar calendar, the solar months, January, February, to all of us. Imagine we fasting every year in the month of summer, and the people living near the North Pole, like Iceland, Norway, Sweden, those countries, for them the summer, they only get 1 hour of night or 2 hours of darkness. Imagine for them to fast from 2 a.m. in the morning till midnight of the day. Every year of their lives, that is not fair. The most just is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the lunar calendar the way every nation, they get every month of the season, every 33 years of the span of the time. Allah revolves the days for us to fast in summer, in winter, in fall, in spring. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so does He changes the times of the Salat also. This month of Muharram, respected listeners, from which our Islamic year begins, it also reminds us of the great migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the time of Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was the leader of the believers, he asked his companions, look, the religions of other faith, they follow a certain calendar. Christians follow this Gregorian calendar where the year starts with a remembrance of the birth of Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, peace and blessings be upon him. But they did not have any significance because at that time Muslims were not following any methodology, any particular calendar. They were following the calendar of the year of the elephant. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabil fil. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu consulted with his companions, what do we do? They could have started the year with the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, like the Christians did with the birth of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. There was a very joyous day, one of the greatest days in the history of Islam, if not the greatest day. They could have started the Muslim calendar with the victory of the Battle of Badr or Battle of Uhud or the conquest of Makkah. He consulted with his companions, how do we start our Muslim year? The companions gave different opinions, but Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala said, O leader of the believers, we should start our year which signifies that we lost a lot, and in return we gained a lot with our sacrifices. And what is that? Said Umar radiallahu ta'ala asked, where we lost a lot and gained a lot in return. Said Ali radiallahu ta'ala said, when we migrated from Makkah to Medina, when we did hijrah, we lost our wealth, we lost our properties, we lost our homes, we lost our family members, we had to break our ties with our relatives. In other words, we lost everything when we migrated to Medina to Munawwara. But in return, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established the religion, the deen, from Medina to Munawwara. So that should be the time our calendar should start. That should be the year. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was so pleased with the response. He said, Ya Ali, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't just tell you, wa aghdahum Ali. Ali makes the best of the decisions. This is what we will start on a Muslim calendar. With the migration, with the hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions from Makkah to Medina, this is 1439 after hijrah, meaning it has been 1439 years since Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated from Makkah to Medina. This month of Muharram, respected listeners, should also remind us about our origins, the sacrifices the companions made, because of which we are sitting here today as Muslims. In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am the result of the sacrifices and the dua of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Rabbana ul'ad fihim Rasulan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quotes the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam in the Quran, saying, O our Lord, from my lineage, bring such a prophet that will bring the humanity out of darkness into light. So we here today, respected listeners, are sitting because of the tremendous sacrifices of the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. Sacrifices we cannot comprehend and imagine. Imagine Umm Salama, the sacrifices of Umm Salama. Her child being snatched away, her husband gone without them, and then she joining him after a year. The sacrifices of Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and his parents, Yasir and Sumayya radiallahu anha, being punished cold-bloodedly, brutally, mercilessly. Words cannot describe the way they were tortured. Both dying in the torture given by the mushrikeen, by the polytheists of Makkah. And Ammar ibn Yasir himself tortured so much, putting his face into the water, waterboarding started by the Quraysh of Makkah, putting him and his head in the water, and telling him to say words about their gods, idols, putting him on the burning sands of the scorching heat of Arabia, putting his skin to the fire, and making him say words about their idol gods. And out of unconsciousness, or not knowing, in that extreme torture, he would say those words. it would shake the heavens in the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses in the Quran to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who immediately came to Ammar ibn Yasir. The polytheists had just given up the torture, getting tired and exhausted, torturing him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks by him. Ammar ibn Yasir has just gained his consciousness, exhausted, in extreme pain. He says, Oh Ammar, did you repeat the things they told you to repeat while they were torturing you? Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu, feeling as guilty as he was, repeating the words of those leaders of the Quraysh and his torturers, he said, Ya Rasulullah, yes, I repeated, I said those words, what they told me to repeat. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled at him and he said, don't you worry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verses to me. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Nahl, Man kafara billahi min ba'di imanihi illa man ukriha wa man qalbuhu mutma'innun bil iman. That if they tell you to speak the words of disbelief, even though your heart was at rest in the belief of one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no sin on you, it is okay for you to repeat those words. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited the words to Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu, when he heard these words, all the torture and the extreme pain seemed nothing to him in front of the comfort and the blessings and the balming effect these words gave to Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Such sacrifices, respected listeners, such torture of Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Khabbab ibn al-Arat radiallahu ta'ala anhu, unimaginable torture. After all those sacrifices, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to migrate to Madinatul Munawwara. And that is the time the Hijrah started, with their sacrifices, Allahu Akbar. Today, respected listeners, a sahabi comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah, ayyul a'mali afdal, which deed is the greatest in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-hijra, migration. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sahabi asked, mal hijra ya Rasulullah? What is hijra, what is migration, O Prophet of Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, tahjuru sunnah, leave the sin. That is the hijrah. وَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَحْجُرُمْ هَجْرًا جَمِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, therefore be patient. Exercise patience, O Prophet of Allah. وَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَحْجُرُمْ هَجْرًا جَمِيلًا. Of what they tell you, of what they're telling you, O Prophet of Allah, they're calling you a madman, a magician, a poet. Whatever they're calling you, be patient, O Prophet of Allah, and lead them with noble dignity. La hijratu ba'd al-fath. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is no hijrah after the conquest of Makkah. Al-muhajir man hajara manah Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a muhajir, the person who migrates is that person who leaves the sin. Who leaves the sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those in this year, respected listeners. The new year has come for us. We make firm determination and resolution to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek forgiveness from the sins we have committed in the past year and in the past life. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from all kinds of sins, major and minor, and to guide us to the straight path. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وأستغفره يغفر لكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, this world we are living in, respected listeners, it has cause and effects. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about hijrah in the Quran says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who have migrated and those who strive in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on these Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala special mercy descends. If a person commits sins, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-Hijra, migration is tahjuru soon. Leave sins. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person commits a sin in the closeness, in behind the closed doors. Nobody is watching him. And he or she commits a sin. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that sin has an effect on a bird called Hubara in the jungles. We committing sins has effects on the birds in the jungle. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then they do good deeds, سَيَجْعَلُ رَحْمَانُ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَانُ وُدًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on them, because of their having iman and because of them doing good deeds, the effect of these, iman and doing good deeds, Ar-Rahman, the most merciful from above the heavens, puts love of those people in the hearts of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angels will love that person, Allah loves that person, the fishes in the ocean love that person, the human beings, Muslims or non-Muslims, they love that person. Today, because of our, you know, my actions, my iman is weak, my actions are not good, because of my actions, non-Muslims don't love me. The Muslims don't love me. Even our own families, we have issues about love and respect. Why? Because we have left those good deeds which are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, to protect us, and to forgive all our sins that the past year, the year has gone by, from all our past life. The past year has been a very difficult year for the Muslim Ummah. We went through all kinds of trials and tribulations and tests. From every perspective you look at and angle you look at. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this year. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would welcome the new year. The Sahaba would welcome the new year with du'as. We're making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma adkhilu alayna bi amni wal iman wa salamati wal islam wa ridwanu min ar-rahman wa jiwari min ash-shaytan. O Allah, make this new year a year of peace and faith. O Allah, make this new year a year where you are pleased with us. And O Allah, make this new year a year of Islam and security. And O Allah, make this new year, protect us in this new year from the evils of shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to do good deeds, respected listeners, to fulfill the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to fulfill the rights of the people also. Let me conclude with this thing. I just remember, we are going through the month of Muharram. We went through the 10th day of Muharram, the Ashura. Many of us fasted on the day of 10th day of Muharram, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam promised the sins of the past year forgiven. But that 10th day of Ashura, the 10th day of Muharram, which just went by last Sunday, also reminds us of the great sacrifices of the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hussein radiallahu anhu. He, respected listeners, he could have accepted the terms and agreements of Yazid, the emperor at that time. But he wanted to give a message to the people in Pleasanton, to the people living in the Bay Area, to the people living in the entire world. Look, even though I am the grandson of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him so many glad tidings of paradise. Al-Hasan wa Husayn, Sayyida Shababi Ahlil Jannah. Hassan and Hussein, when they were infants, Rasulullah gave them the glad tidings of being the leaders of the youth of paradise. In the grounds of Karbala, in Iraq, on that day, on the 10th day of Ashura, respected listeners, only about 40 people are remaining in his army out of 75. 25 have already been martyred. Massive army of enemies have surrounded them. The time of Zuhr has come. Just before Zuhr Salat, he dozes off in the battlefield for a few seconds. In that sleep, he sees Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the dream. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "Oh my grandson Hussein, the paradise has been decorated for you. The doors have been flung open for you. We are waiting to welcome you into paradise." Shortly, he wakes up his eyes. The time of Zuhr has come. He tells his commander Zuhair, who is holding the flag of the Muslims, he says, "Go tell the leader of the enemies, Shimr, that the time of Zuhr Salat has come. We want to stop battle for the few minutes to pray Zuhr Salat." What excuses we will have that I miss my Zuhr because of my work. I miss my Fajr and Isha because I'm tired, because of my business, because of my sickness. When the grandson of the Prophet of Allah, he's from Ahlul Bayt, many glad tidings of paradise have already been given to him. In fact, at that time, there was no need for him to pray Zuhr Salah. He was in the middle of the battlefield. He could have prayed after the battle was over if he was alive. But he wanted to teach a lesson to all of us. To all of us, respected listeners, don't miss your salat, no matter how busy you are. Zuhair goes to Shimr and he says, "Allow us to pray Zuhr. We'll resume the battle after the salat." Shimr says, "You can pray, but we will kill you while you're praying." He comes and tells to Hussein radiallahu anhu. He could have resumed the battle. He says, 20 of you will stand guard while 20 of us are praying." What kind of salat was that, respected listeners? The world has never seen a salat like that, or will never see. Blood coming out of their faces, oozing out of their bodies like fountains, hands and feet broken. They did tayammum on the grounds of Karbala. Was the tayammum with the dirt of Karbala, or was it with their blood? And when they said Allahu Akbar, the angels had never seen a salat. What kind of salat, what kind of sajda was that, respected listeners? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the right path. May Allah give us ability to not miss any salat, to fulfill the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time also to fulfill the rights of our fellow human beings. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروني إلى الباقي. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى